Yeah.
And it was crazy, man. It was actually a challenge, but you know, it was a good challenge.
Bro, it was a good vibe.
There's a lesson in there for a lot of young acts coming up.
Mm. You know what? I'm glad you said this, because while we had this conversation the next day, mm-hmm, in the apartment,
yeah,
when I brought it up and said, "Man, how do you guys feel?" He was like, "Listen, this kind of reminded us of the beginning."
Yeah.
And as, yes, an artist, you need to be on your toes,
on your toes,
and learn how to improvise. So even all these upcoming artists,
and read the audience.
Yes,
you're
read
about
the audience, study
engage
the audience.
With.
So even as an upcoming artist, or as an artist who's, you know, just about to get into the game, when you are on stage, don't just say, "I will give you what I've rehearsed."
What's current? Currently,
yes,
pushing.
You must be able to read the audience. Yeah, understand the audience you are communicating with.
Even in Nigeria here,
right,
when we perform our palm wine sets, I get like 20-30 people come up to me and be like, "Yo, how come you guys don't ever perform Clone Wars stuff anymore?" And so it's completely opposite from what we got in Berlin.
Right.
You understand? So it's like, over here we're doing the palm wine sets,
yeah,
and you know, because for a wider, cater to a wider audience, but people are like, "This guy, we need those, you know, Clone Wars tracks." And over there we did the Clone Wars tracks and we're like, "No, we need the palm wine stuff." So like, it's definitely a balancing act, you know? You definitely have to like,
I feel that's the thing. So we've chosen to take this path where we're going to make different types of albums.
Right.
Like every year we do something palm wine. Every year we venture and experiment on
other things. Stuff. Yeah.
I think what palm wine does, it gives us the freedom to experiment.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. But at the same time, I think what's happening now is that like both of the fan bases are merging.
Right.
You know, so we expect that people that listen to palm wine don't listen to
lie.
It's not that. It's
lie.
Like they listen to both.
True that.
You
yeah.
Know, so.
True that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. We're gonna play the next song, and it just so happens that the next song features Wani, who's also in the studio. Everybody shout out to Wani real quick, man. Wani's in the building.
Wani,
shout out to you, bro. Meanwhile, Wani, you just changed your handle on Instagram. You for tell guys now, because I was not looking for, like, where this guy? I'm not following you. That's right. Let's play the record and then we'll talk to Wani as well, and talk to SDC and just pretty much talk about the Palm Wine Express. Okay, PGM Radio, we're back in a short bit. Stick around.
PGM Radio Show.
We push good music.
Palm Wine Express that we are talking about today. We are exclusively play listening this project today. The song you just heard from Case features Wani, who's in the building. Wani, how you doing, brother?
I'm good, man. Good to be back, Douglas.
Man, Wani, great to have you back. I'm not even gonna lie, man. I was a bit worried about you for a second.
Why are you worried about me, though?
Because you just kind of went quiet for a minute.
I had to, man. I had to figure out the direction. I had to take some time off to figure out the direction. I'm telling you some advice. I wanted to make the next release, like, mean something, you know?
That's right.
Yeah.
I feel you. I feel you on that. But you're good, though, right?
Yeah, 100%, bro.
You're on that Express ticket now, huh?
First time on the Palmine Express. I'm rocking with the big bro, so, hey.
So how did you get on the project?
It's the power of Twitter, man. They hit me up and like, "Yo, list this." I was like, "Yep, let's get it cracking." I sent it back to him. It was a vibe.
Are you serious?
So when you guys were making this particular track, did you have Wani in mind straight away, or was it, how did that happen?
Probably for the beats, because the beat sounds similar to something that I would usually jump do for my own project.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
in the same lane, it made it easier to just like switch, like, you know what I mean, mix up the vibes.
Definitely.
It sounded like something that would be on my project, so yeah. Yo.
Just as Sparks was mixing, he hit me up. I was like, "Come, do you know that this, in case you never know?" Oh, ghost told me. Ghost, my bad. One of them,
the OG.
One of my boss told me, Sparks or Ghost. I don't know, they kind of look alike. So what happened was,
like you and me, dog.
What happened was, so I had to hit two shots up in the US. I had to find two shots, hit them up. It's his track with Timaya. Wow. You know, and both of them, Tushos and Timaya, they gave us their blessing to use the track to clear the sample.
Fantastic.
You know, and it was just like, it was one of those things where you have to even respect the OGs, man.
Yeah.
They actually gave us full blessing.
Solid. Shout out to them.
Solid.
Anytime you hear me, like, because I do it a lot where I interpolate or I sample like old legends, I did it on Legacy Device. It's just to pay homage to like the people who came before me. It's never a thing where I'm trying to like
bite off.
Or like, I'm always trying to give back, like, respect to people who did it before me. Timaya, especially, like, that's somebody that's somebody who I respect. Timaya, Two-Face, Two Shotz too. So shout out to them.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's business, and at the end of the day, facts. Once again, facts, young facts. People or other artists, facts, if facts. You want to come through, if you want to use something, get the permission. Facts. You understand? So you guys doing this, you're helping to change the way people approach and do business.
Also, I'll say, to be honest with you, like Palmai Music 2 is probably our most successful project in terms of numbers, streams.
Are you serious?
But it's also the most stress I've ever had from, like, some artists hit me up like, yo, I wrote this and I didn't know that they wrote this for this person. Yeah. This other person hit me up, some people's managers. So constantly I'm having to deal. So this time I was like, you know what? I don't want stress. Everything needs to be cleared and stressed.
But you know what? I have something different to say to that, because funny enough, this project was one of the projects that Wale and I disagreed on for like a lot of the projects.
Why so?
Like, it was just like, man, change, no, leave your verse like that. No, I'm not leaving my verse like that. Do your verse like, no, we have to add this person. No, I'm not adding that person on that. It was like that the whole way through the whole thing. This is the first time it's actually ever happened like that.
Yeah, true.
But why?
I think
because you just wanted to put out a good project.
Yeah, I also think, to be honest, what happened was like we're in the mindset of another album.
Yeah.
So first of all, we had to make the decision, because that album, what we want to do, what Sparks wants to do on the production side, where we want to go with it, I think like we didn't have the time to really get into it, you know. So first of all, we had to make the decision to actually pause that album for now. Funny enough, I had a call today from like Effia. She called me, she was vexed. She said, how come the song we did didn't make the project? You told me that's one of your best songs. And I actually said to her, like, it is one of my best songs, but not for this album, it's for the next album.
Right.
It's going for sure. 100%. And only one song that was meant for the other album made it onto this project.
Right.
So it was just a lot of like pausing one album, dropping to another one. Changing the direction, figuring out a brand new direction. We didn't want to make Palmwine 3 initially.
We didn't want to do that many tracks.
Yeah.
So wait. So let's go back a little bit. I just thought that the name was just, you know, just a funky name, Palmwine Express. Mm. You've now told us this is not Palmwine Music 3. So hold on a second. So what I'm trying to understand is,
why the name?
How did you guys, first of all, why the name Palmwine Express? How did you guys come to do this project and it not being Palmwine 3? Like,
so,
why?
So the first thing is that, like, me, I like to overkaku sometimes, right? So what happened was,
is it MJ?
Next year we're going on tour. So we're creating a tour, and the name of the tour we're creating next year is the Palmwine Express.
Right.
Right. So for me, the first best way to introduce the tour and introduce
the project,
everything, because the Palmwine Express is basically the vehicle that takes Palmwine music
around
the world. And so that's what, like, so we decided to call it the Palmwine Express just to get people.
Which is another thing that we had
arguments about.
What was your opinion?
No, I was like, we should be careful about putting out music. And although we have, like, I think the beauty of having the creativity and the space to do different projects on different palettes is just the fact that you have that creativity and that space.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't want to get boxed into a certain, like,
lane,
you know, name or a brand.
Right.
That's, but, like, when, like, you know, we definitely spoke about the idea of the Palmwine Express, and I agreed. It makes sense to.
And then Sparks was like, I don't want palm wine again. 2020. You know, I had to beg them because nobody wanted to do palm wine.
We weren't going to do it. Right?
Yeah.
So I got a question for you guys. Yeah. What has changed for you? You're still your artist putting out music, but there is a business mindset change.
Yes.
What is that change, and when did it take place?
I think for me, I would jump in and say that the change happened when we started working with Sparks. That's the best thing I would say. I would say that because I feel like for us, we've always been artists that, you know, our output is a lot. So this creating music, two albums, we put out Buhari Times earlier this year, we put another album at the end of the year. We probably even have another album.
You
know, we're always working. And so to meet a producer finally that is ready to work equally, in fact, even more than us.
You guys,
you know, and he's even, to an extent, even more passionate about some of the music. Like, African Magic is like, look, what I want to do with that project, the way I see it, this is not it. You know, So unless we're ready to go, unless I'm ready to bring in a choir to sing one chorus, like some mad production, and I'm like, bro, like we don't have the time for that right now. Like let's just, we need to put music out. Let's put me. Let's keep this consistency going.
Right.
You know, and I feel like to answer your question fully, I think the business change is just really being confident in a lane of commercial music. You know, and I think Palm Wine Music gave us that lane. You know, we're not trying to sound like anybody else. Like we found our own lane in music.
That's
we're
right.
Able to push that lane completely.
That's right.
And I think that just opened doors for us.
I agree. I agree.
Shout out, and that shout out Feel Alright. I have to go back to the original Palm
That's
Wine.
Right. Oh, Feel
Alright. Yeah. You gotta play that track as well today. I know this is about Palm Wine Express, but Feel Alright makes you definitely.
Okay, okay. Maybe when we end the show. And there's another song on the project called Do Me. Do Me Nice.
Yeah, Do Me Nice.
Featuring Buju.
Yeah.
Ghost, tell us about that record real quick, man.
I heard the like Buju and Tech were in the studio with Sparks, cooked up something, and Buju was in the studio in Tech's house first, and then they created a song, and I was like, yo, I heard it, I was like, yo, that is the vibe. Okay, so he was like, okay, yeah, but that was supposed to be for another song,
another producer.
So we kept that on the side. So Buju was like, let's work again. We did some more stuff. So Buju did another hook. And Tech was like, you know what? That original hook that he did that this guy said was a vibe.
Yeah.
Add that to this thing and see what it sounds like. He added it. He was like, yo, this is fire. So we added both of them together. Bam. Made a hook. I heard the hook. I was like, man, this is fire. Wrote my verse and everything. Was in the studio with Sparks. Where were you in Ghana? I was in the studio with Sparks mixing the stuff. And I was like, and then Sparks played me some, you know, Mologo songs. I mean, Mologo vocals.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And, bro, it was like they wrote the song together.
Yeah.
Okay. And I said, yo, Sparks, you need to add this Mologo to this stuff. You know, let's get it popping. And he did, and it was fire.
I have to think of how we're going to perform the song live.
Yeah.
And Logo does not live in Nigeria. And Logo is on another record on the project. You know, so for me, it was pretty much like, okay, you know what, like, Logo is a dope addition to this song, but it's going to give us that. It's going to be another one of those songs that we can't perform.
Because I know you had a problem with
with every Burna record.
Yeah,
Burna is a huge star around the world, and we can't find him. We had that problem with Falana because she travels a lot. Lady Donnelly because she travels a lot.
Palm Wine is supposed to be a project also that introduces new acts. You never had Buju on any project, any of your projects.
Yeah, but he was still going to be on the record.
I met Buju for the first time, like literally there and then. He wrote the hook for the beats. I wrote a verse. We put it on the track like immediately.
Boom.
So now, shout out Kuvi because Kuvi is very vexed at the moment, possibly. Because what I did was that, like, I was like, actually, this hook will fit better on the Do Me Nice track.
Right.
So I had to call him and beg him. Please,
hey, let's play Do Me Nice featuring Buju. Yeah. By the way, Buju is some cat you need to look out for, man. If you don't know, look out for him. Shout out to my man Deeds who just walked into the building. It's all good. PGM Radio, we're back in the show, but I stay with us.
PGM Radio Show.
Wani, you feeling that record? So, I've been getting some questions on my Insta. Let me just put it out there. Yes, there is a Palm Wine Fest happening this December. Wally, let's jump to that real quick.
Palm Wine Fest, let's go. So Palm Wine Fest, 28th of December, Muriel Collab Park. It has everybody. It's a Palm Wine Express edition, to be honest. So everybody that's on the project, maybe not Bonasha because he's traveling around. But as everybody else that's on the project, some amazing artists. Wani over here is going to perform on stage with us for the first time. We have Buju, Fumbi, Nonso, Amadi. Hopefully Amari as well.
Yeah.
We talk to Douglas
about that. So. Okay.
Yeah,
I just jumped the gun.
So it's gonna be the third edition of Palm Wine Fest. We're also collaborating with a female concert like group called Femme Africa.
Okay.
Yeah,
I know Femme Africa.
So they're bringing like an all female lineup. Like, so artists like Damian New,
fantastic.
Yeah, a bunch of people like that. So it's a different idea. We're also doing a Clone Wars set as well. We're opening the show 7 p.m. We're starting with the Clone Wars set.
No Niger time.
Clone Wars is rap though.
Yeah, so we're starting with the rap.
I got a couple of rappers for you, Wale, man. I'm telling you right now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I mean, the thing is that, so what happened in the London show that we did, for example, is that we had like a lot of artists on the bill.
Yes, I know.
And even last year, we had a lot of artists on the bill. So what usually happens is that we call all our friends, everyone that calls, someone might call tomorrow, my cousin's a singer, she's amazing.